Hi, friends, and welcome back. If you're joining with me for the first time, my name is Pastor Ruth. I'm the pastor of the Longmeadow Congregational Church, United Church of Christ in Auburn, New Hampshire. And I come to YouTube twice each week. I'm here every Sunday with a worship service for the entire church family, but I also get to come here every Wednesday with a special message for the children of our church. And that's why I am here today, to talk to you about a couple of projects that we are doing here in the church, but also to talk about how we do different projects. Every summer, we seek to help our local food pantry with donations, because summer is a time when their donations go down, but their need goes up, because kids aren't able to get school lunches because they're out of school, and so there's extra needs there. We're also going to be welcoming somebody from Anchored in Hope come to speak with us about what they do and how we can minister alongside them. And we wanted to be able to do something on that day. We want to hear about the future, what can we do on a regular basis, but we also want to hear on that day, what can we do for them? And in the past, one of the things that we've done is we did a sock and underwear collection. We just invited people to bring in new socks or new underwear, different sizes for men, women, children, etc., that she could then distribute. And we really enjoyed doing that. So I thought, oh, well, let's do that again. But then I found out that they actually had a real need for things like granola bars and protein bars and cereal bars and things like that. And so we said, oh, well, if that's your need, then that's what we want to do for you. We want to hear from you what your need is and what would be most helpful. And so for all of the month of June, we're inviting people to bring in boxes of nutrition bars, whether they be granola, breakfast, protein, whatever kind of bar. And we have a plastic bin here at the church, sitting here in the back of the church, and we have them, and you can just place them in there, and we are happy to receive those and then to pass them along to Anchored in Hope when they come and speak with us. And so we were thinking also about the Chester Food Pantry that we always serve at this time of year. And in the past, we've always brought them peanut butter and jelly. And we thought, oh, well, we'll just do that again, because that's always a need, we thought. But we decided, you know, maybe we should ask them what their need is. And so somebody in our missions committee gave them a call and said, we want to do this. What do you particularly need? And they told us that they needed peanut butter and tomato sauce. And I thought, well, that's a weird combination, but it really isn't a combination. They're not going to be eaten together. It's just that a while back, they got a huge donation of jelly, but they didn't have a lot of peanut butter. They also had a lot of pastas, but not a lot of sauce to go with them. And so by asking us about peanut butter and tomato sauce, they were able to fill in the gaps and provide people with a couple of different kind of meals that children will like: peanut butter and jelly and spaghetti and sauce. And so we said, yes, absolutely. So we are also doing a drive in this bin over here that you can drop off any donations of peanut butter or tomato sauce. It can be any kind of peanut butter. It can be any brand of peanut butter. It can be any type of peanut butter. It doesn't matter if it's chunky, smooth, whatever. Same thing with tomato sauce. Any size, any brand, any type. And they will all get used. And so we're doing that. And it got me thinking about what it really means to help people. To help somebody, to serve somebody, you're doing something that they need or they love or they would like. Not what you want to do, but what they need. If we're doing just what we want to do, what we think is fun, then we're not really helping them. We're thinking more about us than about them. Proverbs, in the book of Proverbs, it says, if you speak before you listen, it's to your folly. In other words, if you do something, if you think you know the answer, before you really listen, that's a mistake. That's a mistake. You need to listen first. So if we really want to serve, if we really want to do something that's really going to make a difference, is really going to help in the world, then we need to listen to what the needs are. And then look to how can we fill those needs? How can we help that person? So instead of going ahead and donating socks and underwear or peanut butter and jelly, we asked, we listened, and we're trying to fulfill that need. Now, if we had given them peanut butter and jelly, it would have been okay. If we had given them socks and underwear, it would have been okay. But by listening, we're giving them what they most need, and therefore we're being the most helpful. So it's always important when we're, you know, with our friends, and you know, maybe they're struggling with something, and we want to help them because they're our friends, we care about them. And sometimes you think, I know what they need. And we try and do that, but we don't know that that's what they need. The best thing is to say, you know, what do you need? What can I do for you? Or if you do have an idea that you think is good, say, hey, would this help you? You know, you say, like we said to them, would peanut butter and jelly help you? And they were able to say, well, you know, peanut butter would, but we're kind of set on jelly. So we really listen to them. And that tells them not only that we want to fulfill their needs, but that they are important to us. What they have to say is important to us. And we don't know, we don't have all the answers. We don't know everything. And we want to be open because that's what serving, that's what helping is all about. Doing what the other person needs, not what we think they need. Will you join with me in prayer? Lord, we thank you for all these opportunities that we can make a difference, that we can serve in the world in small and in large ways. And we thank you also that we took the time to ask and to listen so that we can do what's most helpful to these people who are our siblings, our brothers and sisters, and your beloved children. Amen. So thank you for joining with me here today. And don't forget, we're going to be receiving an offering all through the month of June, both of these, peanut butter and tomato sauce, and any kind of bars like granola bars or breakfast bars or protein bars, anything like that. And they're going to make a real difference in someone's life because we listened to what they need. Until we meet again, my friends, I love you very much. But above all that, God loves you more than you can ever imagine. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.